Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here today with musicteacher.com, and in this video we're going to talk about barre chords. So if you've been learning chords and you're new to playing guitar, you may have come up to a point where you're just starting to see barre chords appear in the songs that you're learning. So in this video we're going to talk quickly about what barre chords are and how you're going to be using these in your playing. So all the tones you're hearing in this video today are coming from this Jackson Adrian Smith SDX, which is plugged into the Blackstar Silverline Standard. The amp is mic'd up with a Lewitt Audio LCT 440 condenser mic, and you're hearing my voice today through the Rode Go clip-on microphone. Barre chords are often considered to be quite tricky, and many new players will come up against some problems when playing them, such as building the strength in the fingers to successfully bar across all strings. So barre chord gets its name from that. Your first finger is essentially playing flat across all the strings of the guitar. Now, one really cool reason you would want to use barre chords is that you can learn a lot of chords with a very small amount of shapes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you four main barre chord shapes, and with those four shapes, you will be able to play every single major and minor chord rooted on the E and A strings. So we'll start off with six string barre chords. So these are all going to be rooted along the low E string. So an easy way to start with barre chords is to take an E major chord that you've probably played like this, and an E minor that you'd probably play like this, and learn to play these chords now with your third, fourth, and middle finger for the major, and take your middle finger off for the minor. So this can take a while to get used to because this is different to how you would have learned these chords originally. But once you've mastered that, then we can start talking about barre chords. So the bar in the barre chord comes from the first finger resting across all six strings. So I'm actually playing just the low E, the B and the E strings in the case of this chord, because the A, D and G strings are covered by these three fingers here. But it's good practice to get used to playing all six strings with that first finger. So what I'm going to do now is combine those two things. So take your E major chord, shift it up one fret. Now with your index finger, push down across all six strings on the first fret. So these three fingers now are still in the formation of an E major chord, and this finger here that's barring is actually replacing the position of our open string, similar to how you would use a capo with a guitar. So I'm essentially playing an E major chord now up a fret. My open strings are now played by my index finger. What that actually gives me is an F major barre chord, so I've actually shifted my E major chord up a fret. Now the cool thing is, because of the way the guitar is tuned, these are transposable shapes. So if I shift this chord shape to the fifth fret, it's an A major, or if I shift it to the third fret, it's a G major. So to make this system really work, you do need to start learning the names of the notes along the low E string. So make sure you spend a bit of time familiarizing yourself with what notes sit on what frets. The reason this is important is so that you can quickly and easily move these chords around. So if you're playing an F, you need to know that the F is the first fret. So the lowest string here, the low E string, is where we're rooting our chord, and this is where we're getting the pitch of the chord from. So an F would be rooted from this F note here on the first fret. And a C, for instance, would be rooted from this C note here on the eighth fret. But it's the same shape. So if you play that shape all the way up the neck from the first fret up to the 12th fret, you could literally play every major barre chord from F to E. And that gives you 12 new chords from one shape. Now we can double that to 24 chords by simply taking that middle finger out. So what I'm doing now is I'm playing a minor barre chord. So I'm taking this E minor shape, shifting it up a fret, adding the bar to replace my open string. Now this is an F minor. But the same system applies, so this is rooted from the low E string. So this is the note, whatever note I'm playing on the low E string is the note that's giving my chord its identity. So if I'm rooting from the first fret, it's an F minor. If I'm rooting from the fifth fret, it's an A minor. So again, the same principle applies. I could play every note from F to E minor. Thank you. I can also do the same thing rooted from the A string, but this time I'm using an A major and an A minor. Now again, the same principle applies. You want to play these chords without your first finger. So that in itself can take a bit of getting used to, but then the next part is exactly the same. So if I take my A minor chord shape, for instance, and I shift it up a fret, I can now use my index finger to bar across the first fret, replacing where my open string previously was. The only difference in this case is my root note is now on the A string, not the E string. So this would actually be a B flat or an A sharp minor. But the same rule applies. So if I move that to the third fret, which is a C, it's a C minor. And the fifth fret, which is a D minor. And the same is then true for major chords. If I take my A major chord and shift that up a fret and then bar behind it like that, I've got a B flat or A sharp major. Or I can move that up to the third fret, which is a C, or the fifth, which is a D. And I've got the same system. I can play any major chord and any minor chord rooted off the A string with two shapes. Now that major chord shape is pretty tricky, so a simple way that a lot of guitar players lean on when they're playing this is instead of playing the A major chord like this with three fingers, you simply just bar across it there with your third finger or with your little finger, whichever one is easier, and just forget about the high E string. So you're probably not going to be able to get that one to sound clear because of the angle of the third finger or the little finger, but what you will get is a four string version of a major chord. Which will work in the same way, you're just going to lose one of those higher notes. But that's a nice simple way to play a major bar chord. So now with those four chord shapes, you can essentially play any major or minor chord you want, rooted from the low E and A strings. So just to recap, you've got six string major, six string minor, five string major, and five string minor. So now that you know those, why would you use them or how would you use them? So if you're playing a chord progression, for instance, like a G, D, and C, I can use bar chords to give that a different flavor. So I could play a G major here, a D here, and a C here. Or I could play my G major here at the 10th fret of the A, my C here as a 6 string major, and my D here as a 6 string major. Or I could play them all on the same string, so 6 string majors. Or all as five string majors. So using bar chords in this way is very interesting as a songwriter because it opens up a bunch of new possibilities for you tonally, but also if you're playing with another guitar player, gives you a bit of a contrast. So if one guitar player is playing simple chords in the open position, you as the other guitar player can add these higher variations with bar chords and create some really cool textures. And the other reason you'd want to use bar chords is that it actually opens up some new chords that you can't play from your open position, such as B minor, or B major, or C sharp minor, or C sharp major, or basically any note that's a sharp or a flat, which we don't have a corresponding open string for. The main ones that aren't sharps or flats are B, so we've got B minor and B major again, and F. So that's F major and F minor. We don't have an open string position for those chords, unless you play that simplified version of an F you learn in the early stages of playing. So using bar chords will really open up the fretboard. It will allow you to access all these new notes and chords that you couldn't previously play with your simple open chord shapes. And it also opens up a whole new world of texture from a songwriting perspective. And like I said, if you're playing with another guitar player, it gives you different layers of things to play around with and get some really cool sounds. So bar chords are a very, very useful addition to anyone's playing. They are tricky, but if you just practice them, spend a bit of time familiarizing yourself with that shape, make sure you spend time focusing on the strength of the index finger and getting those fingers to sit over the strings that you're barring. So you don't want them to be sort of resting on the strings below and muting them. You want to get those fingers right round, get that index finger strong, and your bar chords will be sounding great in no time. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson on bar chords. Let me know down below in the comments how you've gotten on with integrating bar chords into your playing style. Don't forget to check out PMTVUK on YouTube for more free video lessons just like this. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher in your local area, please check out musicteacher.com. There's a great network of teachers all around the UK waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.